I thought that both computer science and electrical engineering were good fits for me. I was fine with both of them, although I had a preference towards computer science. I saw that there was a website called Codeforces, and I started doing like, you know, two or three contests, but I didn't really have the motivation to keep it up, and I left it there. In IIT Bombay, there is not that much of a craze for competitive programming. People do a lot of different things. I didn't sit for interview placements, I didn't sit for campus placements, I didn't sit for any placements.
Hi everyone, welcome to Coding Ninjas. So again, this week we have an amazing guest with us. We have Mr. Shubham Jain with us. Shubham is a final year student about to graduate from IIT Bombay. And I think he has done amazing work during his 4 years at college. He's about to go to Stanford, so I'm super excited about that. So that's something that he's going to do this year. He has done a lot of competitive programming. He has been a GrandMaster on Codeforces. He was an ICPC World Finalist last year, which is still to happen, but hopefully it'll happen soon and he'll get to live his dream of being an ICPC World Finalist. And along with that, he has done a lot of research work, a lot of papers he has published, which has really contributed to him getting an admit at Stanford. So, hi Shubham, welcome to Coding Ninjas. And would love to sort of just talk about your journey, what all you have done, and hopefully this will inspire a lot of people to do as well as what you have done, and at least they'll get some direction. Welcome.
Thanks, Ankush.
Perfect. So, Shubham, let's get started with, as I understand, you have done your, you're doing your BTech in electrical, right? Like, and now you're going to Stanford in computer science. So I think that's an amazing, amazing switch. So in the sense that getting to Stanford itself is very, very hard, but changing your branch and getting into Stanford, I think that is just crazy. You must have an amazing, amazing profile. What's your GPA that I think does contribute a lot? So what's your GPA at IIT?
Right now it's slightly above 9.8.
Wow, 9.8 you said, right? Like, so are you like a department topper?
Currently in EE, I'm third, I think.
Wow, you're third. Okay. Great. So let's go to the beginning, right? Like, so first of all, what was your JEE rank? Like, how did you prepare for JEE? So just give us a quick sort of snippet on that, and like, how did you decide what college and what branch? So give us a quick snippet on that. Yeah.
Yeah, so I prepared for JEE in my 11th and 12th at Pace in Mumbai, and before that I had like some experience. I had studied at Fiji, but I used to mostly prepare for the Maths Olympiad, so I was very much into Maths Olympiad. And during my 11th and 12th as well, while preparing for JEE, I also continued to prepare for like the Indian National Mathematical Olympiad. So my dream was to make the IMO team. Preparing for JEE, for me, it took a lot of effort because I'm not particularly good with chemistry and subjects which require memorization. So it took a lot of effort, and my teachers, of course, had a large role to play in that. My JEE rank was about 400. And actually, when I got into IITB, I was in the electrical dual degrees team. I changed my branch in the first year to the BTech stream.
Okay. So at 400, you must have been getting like a computer science at some other places, right? Like, or did you sort of knew you want to do electrical, or like, did you not have priority towards computer science like at that time? So asking that because now you're moving into computer science. So why did you choose computer science at that time? And like, or IIT Bombay was what we wanted to do.
Yeah, that's a good question, actually. So I thought about it a lot. And I had like actually looked at all the like syllabus and things that are taught in each of these branches, because of course as a student in 12th you don't really know a lot about what in depth you're going to be studying and what job opportunities are available. So research is very important, and I basically found out that electrical engineering has this part called communications and signal processing, which has a lot of math that I like combinatorics and some computer science topics as well, like image processing, computer vision. So I thought that both computer science and electrical engineering were good fits for me. So I was fine with both of them, although I had a preference towards computer science, but my preference towards IIT Bombay was larger because, first of all, I'm a local. I live in Bombay.
Yeah.
So that is a big advantage. And also, I had cousins who studied at IIT Bombay. I went to visit them and they have had a very good experience with it. So I had an attachment to the institute before I joined.
Sure. So I can totally relate to that, right? Like, in, for example, in my case as well, my first choice was IIT Delhi CS. My second choice was IIT Delhi Electrical, because being in Delhi, like, I like being close to family and like being in Delhi, I think that was first preference. And I wish I was smarter and like that is not how we had decided like what we want to do for the rest of our lives, right? So great. So did you like had you done a lot of programming earlier as well, like before coming to college? Is that something that you were introduced to earlier in your school or something?
So in my school, I didn't really have any type of serious programming. We had this I think Turtle C++. I mean, I don't know. It's like some Turtle program, but it wasn't a language as such. It was just making small diagrams. And in 11th and 12th, I had computer science as a subject, but like, you know, nowadays JEE students don't really study anything for boards. So just in the last 1 month, I had like crash coursed everything, and it really didn't make that big of an impact on me. After coming to IIT Bombay is when I think I actually started learning computer science.
Okay. And so you joined your college in electrical engineering. Now, when did you start competitive programming, and when did that sort of became something that you really wanted to do?
Right. Yeah. So in my first semester, we had this CS101, which is Introduction to Computer Programming. Mm-hmm. And in our lab, sometimes we had these bonus questions, which were very challenging and for me at the time. And these were kind of like competitive programming problems. So I saw that there was a website called Codeforces, and I started doing like, you know, two or three contests, but I didn't really have the motivation to keep it up, and I left it there. But after my first year ended, I decided to take a closer look at it. And I spent my summer basically learning a lot about competitive programming, and that is when I think the career started. So after my first year ended is the answer.
And like, so for you to sort of do well in competitive programming, like, did you have any sort of support system with you, like your friends doing it along with you? Did you have any mentor? So I think that is extremely important, right? Because sometimes it gets really tiring. Sometimes you're stuck somewhere where you need somebody to push you to basically go through this and like get to the next level. So like, did you have any support system around you?
So when I started, I had started under a senior. He was running this project on learning competitive programming, and I started under him. I did it for a month or two, and that is where I, you know, went until expert in Codeforces.
Okay.
And after that, there was no like major support system as such. So I think in IIT Bombay, the current there is not that much of a craze for competitive programming. People do a lot of different things. It was just, you know, basically just me and a couple of people, and we used to discuss. And I think my ICPC team is basically the people who kept me motivated.
No, makes sense. Absolutely. So now from what I've generally experienced, people who are that good in competitive programming tend to spend almost all their time doing this, right? Like, because they really enjoy it, like they tend to spend all their time doing this. But what surprises me is that you, along with this, you have a 9.8 GPA. And along with that, I'm sure like you've done a bit of research work as well to make that switch of a department and going to Stanford as well, right? Like, so have you done a lot of research work as well? Is that something you've done?
So I started with research when I was in my second year, in the middle of my second year. Since then, I've been doing like some form or the other. I've been continuing to do projects.
Okay. And do you have any research papers as well?
So I have published two papers in signal processing, which is a very mathematical area of electrical engineering. And currently I'm going to submit two papers in artificial intelligence.
Wow. So how did you sort of manage all of this, man? Like your GPA, then your research work, then your competitive programming. Generally, if anybody I've interviewed, like who gets really good in competitive, like that's what they do. Like that's what they enjoy. That's what they do. So like, how did you sort of manage all of this altogether?
Right. Yeah. So for me, the priority was, I think, clear from the start that competitive programming is not meant to be a very big time sink for me. At least when I'm in college. So when I'm in college, the first priority has to be research and then grades and then competitive programming. I always view it as a hobby and something that I do when I have like free time or leftover time. How I was able to spend so much time on it, I think basically what I did was I didn't do anything else in my winter breaks. I didn't take internships. Mm-hmm. People do internships often. So in my winter break, I used to spend like a month of concentrated practice, and also my teammates were you know, good enough to not go back home, and instead they used to stay over at my home or in the institute to sit back and practice together. I think that practice really helped a lot.
That's amazing, man. That's amazing. I mean, like, just not spending that much time and becoming a grandmaster, I think is crazy. So what's the plan like going forward? So I hope you get to go to Stanford, and like this pandemic doesn't really stop you from doing that. And so what's the plan post that? So you go to Stanford, you do your master. Like, are you planning to do a PhD or like do a job beyond that? Like, what's the plan?
Yeah, so yeah, that's actually a question that I have been debating for quite a while. So initially the plan was always to do a PhD, but in the past year I have kind of gone against that. I don't feel like a PhD is for me anymore. So that's why I applied only to master's programs. And currently my plan is to do a 2 years master's and then work in the US for as long as my OPT is, and then come back to India and hopefully get a job in the industry which has some sort of research flavor to it.
Okay, that sounds great. So do you have a job offer right now? Like, did you sit for campus placements, or like I'm sure competitive programming would have ensured that you get amazing jobs. So like, did you did you sit for placements or not, and like which company if you did sit for placements?
Actually, the interesting thing over here is that in my like 4 years in the institute, I didn't sit for interview placements, I didn't sit for campus placements, I didn't sit for any of the placements actually. But I did have a job offer. I had a job offer from DE Shaw from my third year internship.
And you did not give interviews and you have an offer? Like, what does that mean? Like, how did you get the internship?
So actually my original plan for my third year was I was going to go to Max Planck Institute in Germany to do a theoretical computer science research internship. But as we all know, COVID happened and it got cancelled. Yeah. And in May, I came to know that DE Shaw is looking for interns. Mm-hmm. So I sent them a mail and gave an interview, and then got the interview. Okay. I got the internship, and then I got a job offer after my internship.
Right. So you gave interviews for that internship, right? Like they didn't just. Or okay. So then you did not sit for so that was the only company you sort of applied to and you got the internship, and then you didn't have to sit for placement because you had a paper.
This was very late, like, so this was in May, whereas the like internship started in May. So I applied in May, and because of the pandemic I had to change plans.
Okay. Yeah, this pandemic has changed plans for almost everybody around us. Yes. Right, like, so perfect, man. This is really, really insightful, and I think like this is a great example of where you are sort of able to manage people in college. You should be able to manage like multiple things and like get really good at all of them, and maybe not 10, but like maybe 2-3 things that you can very well manage. And I think you have done amazing work in last 4 years. I think what all you have achieved is just crazy. So really happy to talk to you. Thanks a lot for coming to the channel, and I'm sure this has been really insightful for everybody who has been watching this. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Ankush.